She turned into a pillar of salt.
I'm sorry?
Lot's wife, you turned her into a pillar of salt all because she looked back at Sodom and Gomorrah.
Yeah?
Don't you think that's a bit overkill?
No.
No?
No.
Why not?
I told her not to look back.
What's the big deal of looking back as the city burns?
I gave her a clear instruction and she ignored it.
It wasn't that big of a deal.
It wasn't that big of a deal?
I invented light within 4 words. I redeemed all of humanity within 3. The very breath that you criticized me with is the one I gave you when I created you. The laws of physics on Earth hold their consistency because they dare not defy what I told them to do. So instead of criticizing my judgment calls, maybe you should ask Lot's wife why she didn't take my words more seriously. I'm gonna go now.
What?
No, alright. I know that sounds bad.
Yes! At last!
Okay, look, I think I have a plan here. Using mainly spoons, we dig a tunnel under the city and release it into the wild.
Spoons.
That's it. I'm out of ideas.
Someone ought to put you in a mental hospital.
Someone should put you in a box floating down the river, Grandma.
Excellent question. I have a phone right here. Let me see. I'm shaking it right now. Okay. This is a phone. Okay. I can very easily make it a coaster for a drink. Right? And it would kind of work. But it wouldn't be the original design of what the phone actually is. The phone wasn't designed to be a coaster. It was actually meant to be a phone where I could record TikToks, talk to my family, and all that. So, it started out as good, but you can distort it and twist it into something that it's not supposed to be. So, we are made in God's image, yes, but we can go out of his original design and twist the lifestyle to represent something that wasn't good for us. I mean, that's same thing with your body, same thing with everything that you can do. Like, we made medicine and twisted it into drugs. We took all sorts of things that started out as good and made it evil, that made it bad. But there is hope and there is grace because it can also go back to the original design. There's nothing that you can do that God can't restore.
Stitch this and tell me about the times that you felt like you were really a part of Christian TikTok. I'll go first.
When I got called a false teacher,
Creep on in.
The power of the sun in the palm of my hand. Hello, Peter. Getting on my nerves.
I 100% agree with you. Sort of. We are all Christians, yes. We all have different denominations. And you guys know me on my page. Like, I don't do Christian-friendly fire. That's not cool. That is not a good thing to do. But we are also called to defend the word. And in doing so, defending the faith, sometimes we gotta ruffle a few feathers. Mind you, the video that this comment is on, this was commented on my page. I didn't go out and seek this. And the severity of the idea of purgatory is, one, it's not in the Bible at all, and two, believing in it basically means that you have to go to purgatory to work off the rest of your sins because you sinned and you're not quite holy enough, which does attack the validity of what Jesus did on the cross. It is an entirely work-based mentality where you have to earn your way to heaven. So that's why I commented on it. Normally, non-salvation issue stuff, I let go, but this one, I was like, nah, I kind of want to talk about this one. Not hating on the church, though.
It's the peasant who I saw leaving the city who disappeared into the crowd with Cusco in the back of his cart. He must have taken him back to his village, so if we find the village, we find him, and if we find him, we find Cusco. Oh yeah, it's all coming together.
She's pretty, but look at her hip dips. Shut up! Look closely! Really closely! There's a bone! And if the skin goes on the bone, then there's gonna be a dip! Cause there's a dip in the bone!
Pulse.
Roger.
Find that bitch chocolate with the V on it. That's what the free on it.
Find that
addition to my collection. Fine addition to my collection. Fine addition to my collection. Fine addition to my collection.
Everyone else is looking at her like, hey, Cody's just a bum. Cody's this, Cody's that, Cody's this. Cody's me, bro. Let me be me. When is that gonna start?
Oi, don't say that. That's not true. That's not true.
When in doubt, Segway Steve! Let's go, Steve. Don't suck. Don't suck, don't suck, don't suck, don't suck. You suck!
Easy.
Easy! Whoa! There we go, that's the one! No, it's not! So close! Steve, be a buddy, Steve! Yes! There it is!
God can speak through a donkey, then God can use anything.
Yeah, that is true. God did speak through a donkey. Because the prophet wasn't paying attention. The donkey was the second option. Stop giving God what he can use. Give God what he wants.
I see a little silhouette of a man. Mama!
Maybe send me an angel. The nicest angel you have.
I have something I would like to say.
So listen up!
When we're discussing eschatological manners, meaning anything regarding to the end times, Book of Revelation, Book of Daniel, anything that's about like the second coming or rapture and everything, can we do this one tiny thing, please?
Just one.
When you start teaching it to other people, can you at least start off your theories and your claims with, I think, and end it with, I might not be right? Because let's face it, when we're teaching Revelations, half of us don't even know what we're talking about. The Jews had the entire Old Testament and they still got the Messiah wrong. Imagine what we'll be like at the end of days when we try to figure out Revelation. Nothing wrong with theorizing, talking about it, making up ideas of what you think the Revelations book could be about, what you think the Mark of the Beast is, nothing wrong with that. But the problem comes when you're claiming your theory and your interpretation of the scripture in Revelation is truth. That's why people think the COVID vaccine is the Mark of the Beast. So can we do that, please?
Someone ought to put you in a mental hospital.
Someone should put you in a box floating down the river, Grandma!